Hello, beautiful people. Today, I've got a really cool video where I'm going to show you guys how to set up an outdoor sort of an interview newscast type of a setup. And there's actually going to be two different setups, and I'll show you how to do them using both natural light and artificial light. So let's get started.
Here we have Ruthie Cruz. She's going to be our reporter for this test setup. The camera that I'm using is a Blackmagic Pocket 4K camera. First, before you ever worry about lighting, always figure out the angle and the framing of your shots. So, this is going to be a medium shot on location, and this is how it looks with the natural light. We have the sun off to the camera left, and this unfortunately produces harsh shadows on Ruthie's face. So, I first remedy that by putting a diffusion material. This can be lots of different things. In my case, I have a flag that I mount on a C-stand. I could just use a solid black flag to completely stop the light, but with the diffusion material, it allows some of the natural light to still light her face from the same angle as the street that we see behind her. But it reduces, obviously, the harshness of that light drastically. Just with this one fix, it's already looking a lot better. Now we need to add another light to brighten up the other side of her face. We can do that in different ways. First, we're going to use a reflector. I have Craig here help me out with that. As you can see, it evens out the light across her face nicely, but it also makes it harder for Ruthie to look straight into the camera with that glare. Since bouncing light back onto your subject depends on the angle of the sun, it also means that it's not always easy to find that perfect position where you're getting the right light, but also so that the talent can actually see without getting too much light glaring in their eyes. Another problem with reflectors is that it's hard to control the intensity of the light. So that's when using artificial light is a lot more useful. Now, keep in mind that whenever you're going to light a scene outside alongside the sun, you're going to need a very, very strong light. So the light that we're using here today is the 600D Pro from Aperture. It's a very nice and very powerful light. And just a few years ago, really, to get a similar output light, you would need to get like an HMI PAR, which is very expensive, big, heavy, and also uses a lot of electricity. Since the 600D Pro light uses LED technology, it means that you can plug it to any regular power outlet. Now, if you're on a location where you don't have access to electrical outlets, you can even power it using multiple V-mount batteries, or even better, you can use a portable solar generator like the ones that I reviewed previously. Now, to make this light a lot less harsh and easier on the eyes for Ruthie, we will be putting some diffusion material in between the light and our subject. Now, getting the intensity and the position of this light is really important. In this case, I will be overpowering actually the sun so that the light now becomes our key light. And in this case, however, it is better to actually have the light slightly higher so it creates some shadows under her chin and nose. This will actually add definition to the face, and it also makes the face look less flat. This already looks great for me, but I really wanted to make the shot look a bit more high key. So I decided last minute to add another white flag. And this time we put it in front of Ruthie, but underneath her face. This helps brighten up those shadows a little bit. This reduces overall the contrast ratio on her face and makes the shot more evenly lit while it's still retaining that three-dimensional definition on Ruthie's face. The final shot looks really nice. It's bright, but without any of those harsh shadows. And this is especially evident when you compare it to what we started with. Now, what if your shot actually requires you to shoot towards the sun? Let's say you're doing a news report and that's simply what you just need to show in the background. Well, then the first thing, always make sure your framing and angle, again, looks good. And then take care of any lens flares. In this case, the sun was shining straight into the lens and I didn't happen to have a matte box to block the light, so I put a black flag instead. With the correct exposure, the shot already, I think, looks good. And that's because we don't have any harsh lighting on Ruthie's face. And in fact, only the ambient light on the location is now lighting her. Now, since I wanted the bounce light to look even nicer, I'm going to use a white flag just off to the right side of the camera. And pretty much that's the finished shot right there. Now, if you happen to have an artificial light like we do, then of course use it. This is especially good if the sun is, for example, going in and out of the clouds, which would affect the bounce light. And the overall exposure of the shot. Just like in the previous shot, you want to put some diffusion in front of the light to make it less harsh. As you can see, it looks great. Now, if the sun goes behind the cloud, we can keep on filming since the exposure on Ruthie is not dependent on the intensity of the sun, but the output of our artificial light. If you happen to have a fancy light, like the Aperture 600D Pro, that has some effects built into it, then you can really turn things up and even make it a party scene. As you can see, the possibilities are endless. Really, you just gotta have some imagination and fun.
All right, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you let me know in the comment section below. Also, make sure you guys give a big shout out and thank you to Craig and Ruthie from UbiFire. I'm probably going to provide the link to their website down below. And check out my website, tomantosfilms.com. While you're there, subscribe to my newsletter so you stay up to date with any future tutorials like this one or maybe other filmmaking gear reviews and things like that. Anyways, that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.